Hello bookishmans, welcome to my November wrap-up part 1. In this video I will talk about the 5 works that I finished in the first half of November. And like I did in my previous wrap-ups, I will insert clips very soon after I finish those works. Today is the 1st of November, and I finished the audiobook that I was listening for 5 days, which was called You Shouldn't Have Come Here by Genova Rose. I added this book to my TBR with the recommendation from Adri at Chapters and Converse. I read this for the prompt of a book recommended by her for the Booktrovert Bingo, created by Audrey. In this thriller book, we follow Grace and Calvin. Grace comes as a guest to Calvin's B&B, and they immediately feel attracted towards each other. And although there are some things that are odd about this place, like having no cell phone reception and Wi-Fi, and also a very shady past of Calvin, Grace could not help but wanting to be around Calvin all the time because of the attraction they felt. And as their relationship progresses, Calvin becomes more and more obsessed with Grace, and Grace becomes more aware that all of the people in this town, including Calvin, are hiding something from her. This was a very decent domestic thriller, and it also had a very fast tempo, and I really liked the writing style of Genova Rose. The plot was interesting. Some details were hidden all throughout the book to prepare us for the surprising and shocking events as we get towards the book. However, although one of the twists was not something that I was quite expecting, the other supposedly shocking twist felt a bit obvious for me. So the ending did not shock me as much as some of the readers. Overall, I enjoyed listening to this really professional double narration. And I gave You Shouldn't Have Come Here by Genova Rose a 7 out of 10. Today is the 5th of November, and I finished one book yesterday evening and one book just now. The book that I finished yesterday evening was called Son Okur, The Last Reader by David Toscana. This book is one of my real life book clubs, and when I saw that it was a book about books, I was very very excited to read it. In this book, we follow a middle-aged man who has a son who lives very very close to him and is the town librarian. And when his son comes to him and says that he found the body of a young teenage girl in his well, he immediately connects this situation with a book that he read and suggests a solution by devising a plan from another book that he read. When the police investigate the disappearance of this little girl, the mother comes to this librarian, and he struggles to tell the fate of this girl to the mother. I really didn't like this book. Although it seems to be about the love of books, it actually had a hatred of many contemporary books and genre books, which I found it very very irritating. And I was heavily annoyed by the character of the librarian. And the son was sort of like a pervert, and the plot was very very weird. The only thing that I liked about this book was the writing style and how the fiction blended with the actual story that was told. I gave Son Okur, The Last Reader by David Toscana a 5 out of 10 just because of its very capable writing style. And the other work that I finished was a picture book biography for middle graders that I read for nonfiction November for the prompt of display. This book tells the very simplified life story of poet who lived in the 13th century, born in Persia and lived in my country, Turkey, before the Ottoman Empire times, Mevlana Celaleddin Rumi. I have always been very, very fond of the very humanistic approach of Mevlana Celaleddin Rumi. And when I saw this picture book in NetGalley, I decided to request it. I really liked the drawing style of this book. It was very, very beautiful. And I loved the use of color. And also the symbol of birds and flowers, and how it connects with the philosophy of Rumi. Because I was not the target audience, I found the story a bit simplified, but it had to be that way. So overall, it was a very decent middle grade picture book biography, and I gave Rumi the Poet of Joy and Love by Russian Kiryev a 7 out of 10. Today is the 10th of November, and I finished the audiobook that I was listening for 5 days. Be Still My Vampire Heart by Carolyn Sparks. I read this book as a part of my bud reading, the Love at Stake series with Amy at Sobek. This is the third book in the series. In this book, we follow one of the side characters, Angus MacKay, the British coven master of the vampire world, who has been undead for 500 years, and Emma, who's a part of the FBI team trying to uncover the vampire world. And when Angus becomes aware of the activities of Emma as the vampire slayer, he tries to convince her to stop these attacks, because she would certainly be killed by the more powerful evil vampires. They decide to join their forces together, fight the evil vampires. And even though they decide to be friends at first, it is very, very evident they would not ever remain friends. Up until 3 months ago, if anyone said that, I would have a crush on a character who is a male vampire, I would have laughed and said that it is not possible. However, this series really changed my view about the genre of urban fantasy. The first two books in the series were very, very humorous, and the romances were quite decent. This third book hooked me at all levels. Like I said before, I was very much invested in the male lead. He was really Soon worthy. And I also really liked the dynamic between the couple. They were both strong characters, but besides some sparring, they chose not to compete with each other. Instead, work together. And I also really loved how the couple was great at communication. This couple was the antithesis of miscommunication trope. Like the previous books, I found the humor to be just right, not too much. However, I chuckled a lot while listening to this book. I can say that this book pleasantly surprised me, and I'm so glad that we made a decision to buddy read this series together with Amy. I want to thank her for helping me to get over my negative bias about vampire books. Overall, I gave this very pleasantly surprising book, Be Still My Vampire Heart by Carolyn Sparks, an 8 out of 10. Today is the 11th of November, and I finished the book that I was reading for my Books of Alfred Hitchcock project, which is Under Capricorn by Helen de Guary Simpson. Book takes place in Australia in the 1800s. A young man, who is the nephew of a British chancellor of the town, comes to visit his uncle. Then, after going idle for a while, he decides to become rich and invest in land and property. And while doing business, he meets Samuel Flaski, who has a very beautiful wife. Charles and the woman become fast friends. However, she has a drinking problem, and Charles helps her to overcome this addiction, and also trying to find out the truth behind the couple's very unhappy marriage. I have not read a so insignificant book for many years. This book was less than mediocre at all of the fronts. The writing style was meh. The characters were bland. The plot was unexciting until the very last 30% of the book. In some of my reviews, I have mentioned that male authors do not know how to write a female characters. And I think the same can be said for this female author. Male characters, including one of the protagonists, is very two-dimensional, whereas the female characters are much more lively. So overall, I gave this very insignificant book, Under Capricorn by Helen DeGuery Simpson, a 5 out of 10. So those were my thoughts about the 5 works that I finished in the first half of November. Please comment down below, have you read any of the works that I mentioned in this video? And what do you think of them? If you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! As for Turkish word of the day, I'm going to choose poet. Poet means şair in Turkish, and şair is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day!